Hi, this is Darren Blue, and I want to talk to you real quick about what a blog is, how it's different from a regular website, and why it's so important to you as an entrepreneur and home business owner. So first, let me explain what a blog is. A blog is very simply a type of website. So really, it's a website that's laid out and structured a little bit differently than traditional websites. A traditional website will usually consist of just pages that are static information, meaning they're never changing. It's just information that's been written there, and it's there for you to go look at, and that's all there is to it. Now, a blog is a lot different. A blog is interactive. It engages readers, and it does that by having pages and posts on its website where people can comment back and give feedback on what's being written. For example, let me go to darrenblue.com, showing you my blog here. The structure of a blog is a little different. So a blog has pages, as I have pages on each of these tabs here. However, a blog also has posts, which are kind of like pages. To me, I still kind of think of them like pages, but posts are very specific because they show up in the middle section of the blog, and they tend to be shorter than pages and on whatever the general topic of the blog is about. For example, if you're a home business owner, then your blog is focused on being about you and your home business. And that's one of the key things about a blog for entrepreneurs, is that it focuses on them and building a relationship with people through your blog. It's very powerful. It's a very important asset for your business long term, because this doesn't come and go. Your blog is always yours. DarrenBlue.com is always going to be mine. No matter what products, what opportunities come and go, which they do in home business and entrepreneurship in general, products and opportunities come and go. So what doesn't, though, is you, your reputation, and the relationships that you build with people. And you do that through your personal blog that brands you as a leader and an expert in your business, your niche, your market, your industry. So that's the key difference between a blog and a regular website. Now, let me show you how a blog works in your overall sales funnel and how powerful it can really be. So I'm going to go down here. Okay, so I'm going to show you exactly how the blog is the root of your sales funnel and why it's so critical to your business. It starts with your blog, which is the center. It's going to be the hub for everything that goes on. And then you have these other platforms like YouTube and Vidler with the video promotion, the Facebook and Twitter for the social networking, and then the Dig, the Delicious, the Reddits, the thousands of others for the social bookmarking. Now, all of these platforms are designed to feed into your blog, not into your sales funnel like so many people do. So many internet marketers do it the wrong way. They send people directly from their Facebook, from their YouTube videos, into their sales funnel. And it's really kind of like a slap in the face for a lot of people, because they were beginning to trust this person and build a relationship with them, and then all of a sudden they realize they just wanted something from them. They just want their money and want them to buy their products. So it's really the backwards way of doing things. What all these platforms are for is to feed into your blog. So with your YouTube videos, your Facebook messages, your Twitter followers, all of those feed people into your blog. Your video references your blog, your Facebook and Twitter messages promote your blog posts, which are helpful, informational, personal. Basically, all of this is designed to build a relationship and build trust with people so they get to know you before doing business with you. And then this all explodes when you really know how to syndicate your content. And all syndicate means is promote your content. When you really know how to tap into some of these networks and promote your content, and you get the search engines involved where your videos, your blog posts, and your bookmarking is being found in search engines, and all of this starts to go viral, then it really just opens up your sales funnel and makes it so much more secure and makes so many more connections for your business and for your ultimately your sales funnel, because this is your sales funnel. Now, from your blog, you can reference and recommend people to your sales funnel, and then from your sales funnel, people purchase your products and your opportunities. Now, kind of the wild card here is when you do paid advertising, because paid advertising such as pay-per-click and banner and newsletter advertising, a lot of times you can't help but send those prospects straight into your sales funnel. You don't really promote a blog on pay-per-click advertising. It doesn't really make sense. People are typically looking for something. They have a problem. They have a need. And your sales funnel is offering the solution to that need and that problem. Now, you can't skip out on the relationship building, though, because your conversion from paid advertising into your sales funnel, which feeds people into your products and opportunities, is going to be terrible because they don't know who you are, they haven't built a relationship with you, and they have really no reason to trust you at this point. So in your sales funnel, what you want to constantly be doing through the follow-up emails and autoresponders, is sending people back to your blog, back to your YouTube videos, your Facebook, your Twitter, and all the posts that you have promoted on your bookmarking, so they can see that you are a leader and you're knowledgeable in your industry and your products. And that way they build this relationship with you before doing business with you. It's just as important in the online world as it is in the offline world. So once you do that, then this whole kind of circle is complete here. And ultimately, everybody's going to feed down through your blog into your actual sales funnel and purchase your products and opportunities. And then it's money in the bank, game over. And that's how your blog is supposed to work, and how everything else works in conjunction with your blog. So I really hope you understand how important your blog is to your business, and how if you have a blog, then you have an asset that really is the core of your business. And not only is it the core, but it's something you can take anywhere from any business, because while the sales funnel and the products and opportunities change, you and your blog don't. So it's the securest form of building a long-term asset for your business. And that's it. This is what the big picture looks like. Thanks for watching.